here, I have to use the concept of array. If I want to store the age of 25 students or 100 students or 1000 students, 1000 variables or those many variables will be required to store those ages. Okay, and it's not good practice to use 1000 variables or 100 variables or 25 variables or 20 variables. Okay, these type of problems can be avoided using one dimensional array. Okay, for example, if I want to store the age of 50 students or 5 students, I'm not using 50 here, I will use 5 students, age of 5 students. It's a data type. I'm taking this age as int data type, int age 5. Okay, then this age will be stored in memory. I'm taking each location, each block of 4 bytes, because int takes 4 bytes in GCC. If its address starts with 20, next address will be 24, next 28, next 32, 36, then 40, and so on. Okay, if location of age, this is array of for 5 elements, okay, if it start, it's the memory is allocated for age from 20, then 20 in plus 5 into 4, 20 plus 20, it will be up to 40. 40 means it will be starting with 40. Okay, some other things will be, some other location will be starting with 40, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36 to 39. These memory location will be allocated to this age. I am taking an example here, okay? And how to access these memory locations? How to make that some element will be stored here, other element here, 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 or and here, or here, 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 and here, okay? Then I will take some index here. I am taking this index as 0, here at 1, 2, 3, and 4. Because I am starting the index with 0, then the highest index will be 1 less than this, whatever is written in the angular bracket in this array. Okay? So 5 minus 1 will be 4. If I have to input the age of 5 students, then I will write a program here, int main int age 5, then one more variable to make two for loop, I will be using I here. Enter the age for I equal to 0, because index is starting with 0, I less than 5 minus 1, because here highest index will be 5 minus 1, so it will be less than 5. Less than 5 means 4 I plus plus. Printf, enter the age scanf percent d. I was using ampersand sign in scanf, okay? Then here age is variable here, age, and index value will be used here, I. 10% A is 0 initially. For I 0, it will be A is 0. I can take it A is 0, A is 1, A is 2, A is 3, A is 4. Okay? Whatever is being input here. For example, A is 0. Enter the A. Some value is input here. For example, 16. A is 1. It will be, for example, it's 14. Next, 17, 18, 15. Okay? Then I have to display it. Printf. Entered is for I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus printf percent d slash n is of I. This is is of, this is end of this for, and here return 0, and this is the end of this main function. Okay, in this way we can input some values, and we can see here we are inputting these values continuously. These are stored at continuous memory locations. Okay. And I will take some more examples here for one dimensional array.